I know there's probably a lot of single people here tonight that are... Now you're probably saying, well, we've talked a lot about being married. None of this applies to me. I'm not ever getting married. Nope, not the kid. I'm just going to date. Yeah, well, that's what we all thought. Then you wake up one morning, you're staring at a mortgage, two kids, and a minivan going, how the hell did this happen? I was just trying to get laid. Well, that's how it happens. See, because when you're single, so much of the focus of relationships is on the physical end of it. I know single guys that can take anything a woman says and turn it into a sexual innuendo. You could have a group of people and a woman could go, you know, I need to get my tires rotated. And I know single guys that are thinking, yeah, I'd like to rotate her tires. Whereas married men are going, you need to get your tires rotated. I know a place right down the street that does it. They're fast, they're cheap. Matter of fact, I think I got a coupon for them here in my wallet. Yes, sir, there it is, right where my condom used to be. See, and I loved being single. I just don't think I'd want to be single again. I mean, for one thing, when you're with somebody new all the time, you run the risk of calling them by the wrong name. Hey, Sarah, I was thinking, did you just call me Sarah? No, I said, Sarah, beer in the refrigerator? I'm really thirsty. What I said. I tell you what, I wouldn't want to have to take my clothes off in front of somebody new. Because back when I was 20 years old and I had to take my clothes off in front of somebody, I'd actually leave the light on and strut a little bit. Not anymore. Let me tell you, gravity is doing its damage. If I had to take my clothes off in front of somebody new, that light would be off and I'd be going across the room like I was being shot at. I do like the permanency of marriage. Never did like breaking up with people. And I guess everybody here has broken up with somebody and we've all heard the breakup lines. There's a million of them. I was picking out a few of my favorites. Like, I need some space, which is half a sentence. The rest of it is, without you in it. I think my all-time favorite, I think we should start seeing other people. Trust me, nobody's ever said that one to you without having somebody else in mind. Guys, if a woman says to you, I think we should start seeing other people, trust me, she has already cut a pony from the herd, and if she ain't riding him yet, she has pulled the saddle out of the barn. I know some people will say, well, you know, sexually it's more exciting when you're single. I don't know about that. You ever tried to have sex with two little kids in the same house? My wife and I put our kids to bed. We're running down the hall pulling off clothes like we're hitting the beach at Normandy. Go, baby, go, 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 baby. Daddy, no! They got me. Start without me! And if it is more exciting being single, it's not without a price. Because the sexual playground's really dangerous today. Being married's kind of like being in the National Guard. We may not be seeing as much action as the front line, but we are living to fight another day. And besides, married people will tell you, you don't get married to get sex. Getting married to get sex is like buying a 747 to get free peanuts. Well, if all you want is peanuts, there's a lot more cost-efficient ways to get them. And it is true, things are going to cool off a little bit. I got an Uncle Fred and Aunt Doris, they've been married 52 years, and if they're sweating in the back of the car, it's because somebody locked them in the trunk. But think for a minute, there are advantages to having the same partner over a long period of time. I mean, for one thing, you kind of learn what your partner wants and what they like and what they need. When you're with somebody new all the time, you don't have a clue. It's like playing pin the tail on the donkey blindfolded. Go a little bit to the left. No, the other left. You're not even in the same room. Are you trying? See, after 13 years, I know the combination to my wife's safe. 13 to the left. 18 to the right. 9 to the left. You're welcome, baby. Da-na-na, da-na-na. And you ought to work on your technique. You really should, because that's the only part of the whole thing you have any control over. The rest of it, you're just playing with what the good Lord dealt you. And whoever said all men are created equal has never been in a locker room, I'll tell you that. And women think they have a handle on this one. I've heard you talk. Well, if he's got big feet, then you know. Or if he's got big hands, or if he's got a big nose, or if he's got big ears. Well, let me tell you something. He better be packing, because that's one goofy-looking guy right there. And as silly as it seems, guys still worry about this stuff. And women, bless your heart, you're always trying to make us feel better. Oh, honey, it's not the size of the ship. It is the motion of the ocean. Well, that may be true, but it takes a long time to get to England in a rowboat. And speaking of time, you ought to learn to take your time. Because when it comes to matters like this, I have found women are kind of like diesel engines. You know, it may take a little bit to get them going, but once you do, they can run a long, long time. Men, on the other hand, we're more like bottle rockets. Ooh, ah. And I don't know why that sleeping happens, but it does. There is some kind of energy transfer taking place in this act. Because when we get through, my wife can jump up out of bed, run in the kitchen, make a sandwich, vacuum the living room, clean out the garage. You might as well put crime scene tape around me, because I ain't moving. One time I tried to get up to go get a glass of water, I looked like a newborn giraffe on one of those wild animal shows. Good night. God bless y'all. Thank you for coming out. Take care. Good night, y'all.